Patriots. Number 10, Mike Cutter. At the other guard position, 61 inches. Number 45, Donovan Mitchell. In the middle, 7 feet 1 inch. Number 27, Rudy Gobert.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Game 3 of this Western Conference first-round series. We're 2-0 so far, and we'll see if the home court advantage holds sway. And tonight, we'll see the Dallas Mavericks as they go up against the Utah Jazz at Vivint Smart Home Arena. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And joining us on the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Kevin, thank you very much. We know Rudy Gobert is ultra-competitive, but he knows it's not about winning his individual matchup. He said, it's a five-on-five game, a team concept. That's always been my mindset. Obviously, I take pride in being the best defensive player in this league, but I play to win. That's my focus. Kevin?
Thanks, David. That's David Aldridge, our NBA Hall of Famer. Now, we'll look at Dallas's starting lineup. Kleba is the four with Porzingis in the middle. Josh Richardson out there with Luka Doncic. And it's Hardaway in at the small forward. And for Utah, Mitchell is the two with Ingles at the three. Bogdanovich out there with Gobert. And it's Conley in at the point guard position. And it's going to be the Jazz off the tip. The pass to Ingles. Mitchell with it. Bogdanovich left side. Pass to Conley. Porzingis with the block.
You know, when you drive the lane, you have to know where Porzingis is, because with his reach, he can sneak up and send that shot away anytime.
Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
First point of the night, and you know this is going to be a battle of matchups.
What's going to be fascinating to watch is which matchups are they willing to go exploit.
That's good from Richardson. Jazz have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Now Mitchell. And then Mitchell with the dunk.
There is a level of physicality, and the frame of Donovan Mitchell allows him to finish through contact.
Doncic against Conley. Count that one.
Well, the touch and the focus. What a pretty move in the lane.
Jazz have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Outside Conley. Bogdanovich passes to Conley. Another miss by Conley.
Just one made field goal in five tries. Not a good start.
Ingles with the ball. Hardaway picks him up. Porzingis with the block. Here's Richardson. He can't hit that time. Good D by Mitchell. Takes the three. Another miss by Utah. Mavericks have gone 2-3 here to start up the game. Here's Hardaway. And the call on the shot. It sends him to the line.
Well, this is a quick and decisive offensive player who's not afraid of contact. Love Tim Hardaway Jr. accepting the contact.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now. First one falls for.
You see, to me, guys, for Tim Hardaway Jr., there's still another level for him to reach. He has proven that he can be a big-time scorer. To me now, it's about consistency and doing it night after night after night.
Hardaway hits them both. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Here's Mitchell. Another miss by Utah.
And so it's Porzingis. They'll bring it up for the Mavericks.
It was a big win for them coming off Tuesday's match.
I thought they had a solid game plan coming into that one, and then they made good adjustments along the way.
I thought their game plan was really spot on, and we saw that in their scoring more than anything else.
And that was a great replay we just saw of our Mobile One block.
And you've got to take your defense up a notch in the playoffs. He takes it up about three notches on that block.
Now here's Gobert. Got a piece of it. Here's Porzingis with fast break chance. Richardson up top. Offered by Mitchell. Richardson the pass to Porzingis. Six to shoot. And here's Doncic from the arc. Good on the triple. Doncic has got five now.
Well, that's about decision making and being comfortable in the pick and roll. For Luka, he's been there and done that.
Richardson against Mitchell. Pass to Bogdanović. On the wing, Engel. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket.
Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
Hardaway kicks to Doncic. Top of the key, Porzingis. Good, and the assist goes to Doncic.
80% from the field to start, playing with a ton of confidence.
Richardson against Mitchell. Gobert dishes to Mitchell. Shoots from 14, and the shot goes down. Mitchell's got his second bucket tonight.
Now you give Donovan the mid-range jumper, he will make you pay.
Richardson the pass to Kleba. Porzingis kicks to Doncic. Basket counts. Doncic has got his third basket of the night right there.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
And a first time out of the game called for Utah.
Good timing. They're really struggling offensively.
Sometimes it just feels like misses become contagious. He wants to settle his guys down right now.
Mitchell with it. Back to Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
I think we think of Donovan Mitchell first and foremost as a scorer, but I love seeing his passing ability come into play.
Well, they'll get another chance. Richardson against Mitchell. Shot clock at six. Kicks it out to Richardson. Over Mitchell. Good D by Mitchell. Jazz trail by eight, down low. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That one on Richardson.
When Donovan Mitchell is this close to the cup, the defender has got to feel a bit uneasy.
The Jazz shooting their first free throws of the game.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one.
Boy, this is as exciting a combo guard as there is in the NBA. Donovan Mitchell's craftiness, his assertiveness, all of those things make this guy special.
And
Cam Mitchell drops them both.
You want to contest this guy's shot, but you absolutely don't want to send him to the line. He will make you pay.
Doncic looking it over. Pass to Hardaway for three. Gobert pulls it in. And so it's Bogdanović who brings up the ball for Utah. 6-point game.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that's in.
And then Hardaway with the dunk.
How about that burst of speed? Tim Hardaway Jr. Whoa!
Mitchell outside. Inside. Here's Gobert. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist.
There's real synergy in play right now on the offensive end. The pass was right where it needed to be.
Doncic against Conley.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
But quick look, no good that time.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
And Hardaway gets it to go.
What a pass by Luka Doncic. He's got tremendous size, and obviously they want the ball in his hands.
Now, here's Mitchell. 6 points for him. And he uses the glass on the lane. Mitchell's got 8 points.
Boy, it seems like every shot he puts up, it's going in. This guy is hot, hot.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game. Almost entirely new group here. Derek Favors checked in for Rudy Gobert. Ilyasova comes in for Bogdanović. O'Neal's checked in for Joe Ingles. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. Then for the Mavericks, Dwight Powell's checked in for Maxi Kleba. Trey Burke comes in for Josh Richardson. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Tim Hardaway Jr. Here's Mitchell. After Luka Doncic's bucket, Mitchell with it. Out guarded by Porzingis. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Well, you've got to credit Mitchell for staying aggressive in that situation and getting the defense to foul him.
This is his second trip to the line in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good. And Mitchell drops them both. Mavericks leading by six. To the inside, Doncic. Ilyasova comes up with the rebound. Utah's gone 0-4 from three-point land to start out. Looking cold from outside. In the corner, it's Clarkson. Shot clock at five.
You love the anticipation there. Made sure to box out, knew where the ball was going, and doesn't let anyone impede him from pulling in the glass.
It's good. And the Mavericks by eight.
You have to love the intensity that Powell plays with on the glass, using that long body to track down those offensive boards.
Mitchell finds Clarkson. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now one for two.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
To the left wing.
Here's Burke. He dishes it to Powell. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Boy, Powell is proving to be a handful inside. Does a good job utilizing his long arms to get the call.
It's his first trip to the line. First one at the line is good.
Boy, Dwight Powell is such a hard-playing, athletic big man. He could fit himself into any scheme right now.
Willie Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Dallas. And good on the second, so he makes them both. So it's the Jazz now, trailing here by eight. The pass to Clarkson. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Mitchell's got three assists in the game. Burke, the pass to Brunson. Hodges outside. Goes up on the wing. Favors with the rebound. Utah's gone 1-5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Out of bounds, it'll be Mavericks ball. George Niang, he's checked in for the Jazz.
George Niang.
Mavericks leading by five. Up top, Burke. Defended by Ilyasova. Brunson. Rebounded by Donovan Mitchell. And it's Mitchell with the ball for the Utah Jazz. A shot by Clarkson, no good. To the middle. Cauley-Stein finds Doncic. That's good. He's 5 for 9.
Boy, what body control from the Slovenian forward. Doncic comfortable taking on all challengers.
Passes it to Favors. Clarkson surveying the floor. And he dunks it down.
I'll bet even they didn't think the pick would work that well.
No, no, no. And they get the major league dunked out of it, too.
And my question is, where was the help? Someone rotate over and challenge.
And Doncic gets it to go.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Here's Mitchell. Oh, and the dunk by Mitchell.
Well, why did Donovan Mitchell win the dunk contest? Case in point right there.
Here's Burke. No points in the game yet for him. Pass to Powell. And that one is good.
And when the size advantage is as big as it was there, I mean, that's exactly what he's supposed to do in that situation.
Mitchell passes to Favors. Now the dish to Clarkson. Pull it in. And here's Brunson. On the wing, Doncic. Drains it from beyond the arc. And it's a 10-point Dallas lead.
I'll tell you, this guy is proving to be a problem for the defense. In this quarter, he has been special.
Mitchell is double. And that's a foul called on Dwight Powell. That's foul number two for him. Mitchell gets to Clarkson. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Niang. Shoots over Burke. Here's Ilyasova. The shot from the low post is good.
Well, you have to be cognizant of where people are when the shot goes up. Defenders not blocking out in that instance.
A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. Mavericks lead by eight. We've got more in store for you right after this.
And always interesting to hear from Donovan Mitchell, who recently spoke about the team's progress.
Everybody had their expectations of what we should be or will be, but at the end of the day, you know, we got to be able to focus on us, you know. Obviously, we went through a little bit of a rough patch. You know, we're still figuring things out, but we can make adjustments and continue to build. And I think we're playing great basketball. I think we're doing things the right way.
And you know, Greg, Mitchell's going to be right in the middle of it, leading the way.
And on top of everything else he does, he's elite at getting his own shot. We've seen him carry this team offensively at times. Boy, he is special.
And we're back with you, all set to bring you more action from Game 3. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Mavericks?
I love their effort, contesting shots, trying to intimidate here early on.
Well, as a shooter, when the ball is sent back in your direction enough times, it can certainly have an impact on your mind.
On the court for Dallas here in the second, they've got Cauley Stein. Powell is out there with Luka Doncic. Then it's Jalen Brunson, and it's Burke in at the two-guard. Here's Clarkson, and he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
How about Jordan Clarkson? The ability at his position to absorb contact and finish the play.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. The Jazz making a switch here. Gobert's checked in. Dallas also making some changes. Hardaway's checked in for Doncic. And Josh Richardson subbed in for Burke. He throw good. Clarkson.
The one thing with Clarkson, sometimes he can get a little out of control. And he does a tremendous job creating offense and putting himself in a position to attack.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's going to be on Rudy Gobert. The Mavericks haven't yet missed a free throw. 5 for 5. And the first one drops.
And what I like about Cauley Stein is just how hard he plays. Really, both ends, a scrappy player.
And Utah making a change here. Ingles is checked in. Cauley Stein hits them both. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. Now, here's Clarkson. 10 points for him. Conley's shot is off.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the chart.
Jazz trail by 11. Down low, Niang, and he caught that pass in full stride on his way to the big slam.
There's a reason Mike Conley's teammates love playing with him. If you're open, I promise he'll find you.
Gobert with the block. Conley against Brunson. Clarkson on the wing. A pass to Gobert. Pocket six. The Jazz need to get off a shot here. That one doesn't go. Now the Mavericks take it the other way. Inside, Cauley Stein. And Cauley Stein throws it down.
Cauley Stein, a tremendous athlete and a dynamic finisher.
Here's Gobert. Cauley Stein with the defensive effort. Dallas leading by 11. Here's Hardaway. He takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Hardaway has got 8 points.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score, continue to build your lead.
Got a piece of it.
And with him missing literally everything he's put up today, you can see why the score is what it is. It's impressive, the level of domination at both ends, and you're seeing the results.
You know this. It's not easy building a lead on the road, but this team has been lights out throughout the game.
Knocks it loose. Stolen by Brunson. Richardson the pass to Hardaway. And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Gobert, that's in there. Conley with the assist. He has 6.
Gobert has a thin frame, but make no mistake, he is physical and he relishes contact.
Here's Powell, rebounded by the Jazz. Gobert's got his 6th rebound on the night. Ingles kicks to Conley. Gobert the pass to Clarkson. There's the triple. Offensive rebound. And slam dunk by Gobert.
I love it when Rudy Gobert crashes the offensive glass, uses those long arms to great advantage.
Pass to Cauley-Stein. Here's Richardson. Utah with the rebound. Now Ingles. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him.
Boy, he's been cooking, but the teammates, he's just not getting a lot of support from them.
Dallas calls timeout.
Yeah, things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
Well, night in and night out, sometimes it's a battle of runs. Who has the most?
Bogdanovich has checked in for George Niang. And Royce O'Neal subbed in for Jordan Clarkson. Then for the Mavericks, Porzingis is coming in for Cauley-Stein. And it's Maxi Kleba in for Dwight Powell. Brunson with it. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D.
Jazz ball.
Here's Conley. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
You can see the defenders try to play with a level of physicality against Mike Conley, but this guy's such a tough competitor, he'll get to the line.
The Jazz shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good.
What an athletic lineage from Mike Conley. Of course, Mike Senior, triple jump gold medalist at the 92 games. Mike Conley for over a decade has been a tremendous NBA player.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. And so it's Brunson with it. He brings it up for the Mavericks. 17 points was their biggest margin. This one for 3. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. And the shot goes in from Kristaps Porzingis.
Well, that's a good strong finish. Porzingis not shying away from getting after it.
Ingles dishes to Conley. Shoots over Brunson. And the shot is good. The Mavericks lead has been cut to just 9 on the basket from Conley.
They seem to concede that shot, and his response is, thank you very much.
And here is Kleba. He's still scoreless so far in this one. 5 on the clock. On deep. Bogdanovich grabs the miss.
And he's a good shooter from outside, but not sure from that deep.
Boy, we're seeing it more and more. Guys looking to create additional space by stepping back further from the line. Boy, the wheels have definitely fallen off in this quarter. He cannot buy one.
And here are the Jazz now. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. Conley with the three. Another miss by Conley.
I'll tell you, it feels all night like this guy's been forcing shots, rushing shots. He's really struggling on the offensive end. Pretty dime there. The kind of ball movement coaches love to see.
Here's by. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And getting to the line and hitting your free throws, a good way to get back into the game. It stops the clock and extends the game and allows you the opportunity to set your defense. They've been perfect in the line so far here.
Take a break.
In the second
Take
quarter.
A break. Two shots.
The first one falls.
And it's been an outstanding game for them at the free throw line, not missing their chances when they get them.
Derek Favors checked in for Utah. Donovan Mitchell comes in for Joe Ingles. Luka Doncic, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Burke comes in for Jalen Brunson. And so Bogdanović kills both of them.
And guys, Bogdanović, the former second-round pick, has really found his place in the NBA. This guy is an effective shooter from just about anywhere. He has that confidence rolling, hitting two threes in the first, and he hasn't had one since.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
The finish and transition, nice and easy.
Doncic with the bucket.
This guy has been a catalyst for them all game long. What a job leading them to this lead.
Passes it to Favors. Nice ball movement by Utah. He gets that one. O'Neal's got his first points of the game.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
Doncic with the bucket.
Listen, this is becoming routine for Luka Doncic. This guy's a big-time scorer who can take over when he's ready.
Mitchell finds Conley. Looking to get back on track here. Doncic with the block. Here's the three. But they recover it. Richardson against Mitchell. Here's Doncic. And they had their chances. Two offensive rebounds. But they still come up empty. Mitchell looking it over. Over Richardson. And it's Mitchell missing. And Favors kicks to O'Neal. Pass to Mitchell. Over to the wing. Now here's Conley. Burke covering. Mavericks leading by nine. Richardson gets a wide open look. And a miss there on the triple.
I'll tell you, he's trying to help them extend this lead, but it's been a tough night for him individually.
Mitchell outside. No good on the three. And so it's Porzingis. He'll bring it up for Dallas. 17 points was their biggest margin.
He's still filling out that frame, but the Greyhound physique of Porzingis well-suited to transition play.
And the Jazz call time here.
And no doubt, coach wants them to shore up their interior defense.
I think right now they're giving up way too many easy looks. That is a recipe for disaster.
Sova has checked in for Bogdanović. And there's a minute 45 left to play here in the half. Now here's Conley and the foul on Josh Richardson. That's foul number two for him.
To a certain extent, you like the aggressiveness, but that's two fouls already. Take a step back.
The Jazz have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9. 1:36 left in the first half of basketball. Back to Mitchell. Just 5 on the clock. Another miss by Utah. Dallas leading by 10. Here's Richardson, and the rejection by Favors.
Derek Favors using that long frame to send that back twice on the pipes, Kevin.
Clarkson, he's checked in for the Jazz.
Jordan Clarkson.
One 11 left to play here in the second quarter. And the shot is good.
Well, Jordan Clarkson loves the offensive end. He's in the flow on that drive. That's nice.
Pass to Burke. Here's Doncic. Porzingis. Porzingis on the follow. Porzingis has got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Clarkson passes to Ilyasova. An easy 2 points on the layup.
Boy, outstanding pass and execution. They'd love to see Clarkson do that on a consistent basis.
Burke dishes to Richardson. Now Burke still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Cleveland, no good.
I always like to hold for the last shot right here.
Well, that's great execution if you can do that, because it takes any chance at momentum away from your opponent.
Doncic with it. Puts up a three. Hands it from downtown. Doncic has got 25 points.
Man, that is ridiculous range from Luka Doncic. Yes, step across half-court line. I'm in my range.
And so it's Dallas in control with a 9-point lead to end the quarter. A terrific tempo and a great pace. The fast break has been a central part of their offense. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Quinn Snyder. Quinn, what concerns you most about the first half?
Well, I think the tempo is in their favor right now. They're fast, and they're getting up and down the floor. So they're running out in transition.
Got to beat them to the punch. Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And hello again. What a showing tonight. A sold-out building is where the action is happening. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Well, for the Mavericks, they've played exactly like they'd expected to, given the first two games. They're just one half away from taking what would almost certainly become an insurmountable 3-0 lead in the series. Shaq, what's your take on that?
Man, I know he's 20 years old, but it's been fun watching Doncic do his thing like that. Look, his team depends on him to score, and he's doing just that. Nothing the defense is doing has slowed him down. He plays at his own little pace.
And Kenny, let's get your input on the Jazz.
They didn't really show the effort on the boards they should have. They were out-rebounded, and now they've really got their work cut out for them in the second half. If they're going to come back, they need to put in a much better effort on the glass.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See you, everybody, with Kevin Harlan.
Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action on the court. You know, Luka Doncic has been exceptional here, guys.
With so much on the line tonight, you have to be impressed with the way he came out and set the tone with his aggression.
You get the sense when there's big-time performances to be had, this guy wants to take part. You expect that this is a trend that will continue here.
Rest in peace to the mind. Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. Conley and Mitchell, the talented backcourt pair. Joe Ingles is out there with Bogdanović, and it's Gobert in its center. That's the group starting the second half for Quinn Snyder.
Wow, what the power and the strength of Bogdanović on that strong finish.
Here's Doncic. he's got the and one chance here to make it a three-point play.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Now, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for. What's consistency. Up? They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
That free throw good from Doncic.
And I think, guys, over time, you would anticipate Luka Doncic becoming more and more of a leader. This guy is so fun to watch from a skill perspective.
Back to Gobert. Kleba with the rebound. Kleba's got four rebounds in this game. From deep three-point range, Richardson no luck. Jazz trail by 10. Here's Mitchell on the three off target. Over a minute gone here in the second half. Mitchell against Kleba. Tried to bank it in, but he missed it.
Listen, that's a shot he can make, but obviously the defense okay letting him shoot it. Guys, how often do you see an alley-oop designed for your guard? Donovan Mitchell defies explanation.
It's Richardson on the wing. The pass to Porzingis. That shot, no good. Gobert with the defensive effort.
1 for 5 has got to be a frustrating start, and they just don't look sharp right now. Can they find their offensive game?
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing.
Bogdanović staying confident down low, being physical with the defense, and gets rewarded with a trip to the foul line.
These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. Throw good by Bogdanović, and the Mavericks making a change here. Cauley Stein's checked in. And so Bogdanović nails both of them. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Doncic passes to Cauley Stein. Here's Kleba, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Shot clock at 6. Hardaway against Bogdanović, and they pick up 2.
Well, in today's NBA, you've got to be able to play in pick and roll, and Hardaway doing work right there.
They double-team Conley. He kicks it to Ingles. Another miss by Utah.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Just lucky he was off.
Hardaway passes to Richardson. Doncic outside. Off target with his 3. Jazz trail by 8. Bogdanović, that's for 2. It's rebounded by Dallas. Doncic has got 6 rebounds in the game. Goes in there.
We know this. Doncic is an aggressive, thirsty scorer. If you allow airspace, even in the mid-range, he's going to make you pay.
Ingles against Hardaway. Mitchell. Yes, indeed, it is good. He's now 8 for 14.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Passes it to Kleba. Three-pointers off the mark. So Gobert will bring it up for the Jazz. 3-point game.
Very hard to stop Bogdanović. He's excellent at keeping his follow through despite taking the contact.
He's had 4 chances at the line, made them all. The Jazz making a switch here. Niang's checked in. Dallas also making some changes. Dwight Powell's checked in for Maxi Kleba. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Richardson. And that one misses. Mavericks leading by 6. Hardaway with a wide open look. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got 4 assists now tonight. Conley finds Bogdanović. Shoots over Brunson. Utah getting another chance here. And And the rejection by Pauly Stein. Takes it off the glass. And now it's a 10-point Maverick lead.
Well, Tim Hardaway Jr., a better playmaker than maybe people think. This guy very good at breaking the defense down.
Niang passes to Gobert. And Bogdanovich throws it down.
A power flush with a long hang on the rim at the end of that.
That could be a catalyst for him. It really could. And the Mavericks call time here.
Every time out, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
And the guys get a little bit of a break, mentally, physically, just recharge here quickly.
Away kicks to Doncic. And they double up Doncic. Brunson with a clean look. Rebound, Utah.
Well, you simply have to shake that one off, right? You can't let that kind of missed opportunity bother you.
Bengals, that's for two. The shot missing. And it's Dallas the other way. And even 3-on-3 break. Floats one up. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Doncic. A fantastic mobile one block. This one deserves another look.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
A different look for Utah. Derek Favors checked in for Gobert. Ilyasova comes in for George Niang. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Joe Ingles. And Dallas with a change here too. Trey Burks checked in for Luka Doncic. Jazz trail by 8. Looking to end his cold spell. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
That's good from Conley. Dallas leading by 5. Pass to Burke. Hardaway with it. Powell kicks to Brunson. And it's blocked by Conley, and he gets it back. 4 on the shot clock. A second chance effort. Brunson, good. Brunson's got his second bucket.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Derek Favors taking 2 shots.
And he makes the first.
But I think for Derek Favors, it's a matter of continuing to improve your game, especially on the defensive end of the floor.
O'Neal's checked in for Bogdanovich. And so Favors nails both of them. And here's Brunson. He'll bring it up for the Mavericks. Leading by 5. Outside Hardaway. Offline with his 3.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Ilyasova, no one around him. A 3-pointer, no good.
man, they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
To the paint, here's Powell. That one falls coming off Burke's feet. Powell's got 10 points.
How about the skills of Dwight Powell down low? Hard for the defense to match up with his length.
Yeah, that one put him over the limit, and it's so early that if they're not careful, this could turn into a parade at the free throw line.
And he knocks down the first one. O'Neal hits them both. Dallas leading by five. Pass to Burke. Outside Hardaway. Sinks the triple. 17 points in the game.
Ooh, finally hitting one from range. That's his first three of the night.
And here's Clarkson. 12 points for him. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's going to go on Trey Burke.
This, to me, is when Clarkson is at his best. When he's pushing the action, being aggressive, it carries over to the rest of the team, guys.
The first free throw is good. Both free throws good for Clarkson. Mavericks leading by six. The pass to Cauley-Stein. Now here's Powell. He's got 10. Shot from 16. Favors with the rebound. He's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. They double-team Conley. Favors with the ball. Now defended by Cauley-Stein. Back to Conley. Drops in the tray. Conley's got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, Mike Conley, we know his pre-shot preparation is excellent. Catch and shoot, but yes, sir.
Now Powell passes to Brunson. Down to five on the shot clock. Hardaway has a two-pointer. They get it again. Powell. Here's Burke. Another three for Dallas.
Well, they love to see Powell keep his eyes up and look for his teammates. The more assists they get out of him, the more dangerous their offense will be.
And no one near Clarkson as he lets it go. Trying to come right back with a three of his own. It's no good. To the inside. And then Hardaway with the dunk.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. And the Jazz call time here.
And sometimes from the outside, not always clear what led a coach to call for a timeout.
And as you know, it's what comes after that gives you some sense of what has changed.
The Mavericks also with a sub. Porzingis has checked in. Here's Clarkson. The Jazz with another miss. And so it's Burke who brings up the ball for the Mavericks. 17 points was their biggest margin. Mitchell in the corner. Mavericks leading by eight. Hardaway from outside. Another three for Dallas.
Well, Tim Hardaway Jr. is known as a scorer. Knocks down the long distance look right there.
outside Favors. Back to Conley. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. Conley's got 8 points here in this quarter.
And really just led him to his sweet spot for that finish.
Porzingis finds Powell on the three. Utah has gotten 1 of 6 three-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. On the wing, Mitchell. Pass to Clarkson. From outside, off the mark. The Mavericks shooting right around 46% from the floor in the third quarter.
All these threes they're giving up have really been the driving force on this run.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
You see Donovan Mitchell finding his rhythm. You're in for a long night. He is effortless offensively.
Some nice passing here by Dallas. He gets it in there. Brunson's got his third basket of the night.
You know, you have to like that he's still getting quality touches and delivering now after getting blanked in the first half.
Pass to Mitchell. It's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got his 8th assist in the game.
How impressive is the catch and shoot game of Donovan Mitchell? I'll tell you, you better be there on the catch or he's going to make you look silly.
Got a hand on it. Pass break. Here come the Jazz. Mavericks leading by 9. Burke, the pass to Hardaway. Porzingis against Ilyasova. Porzingis kicks to Brunson. Just 5 to shoot. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And the foul goes against Utah. The Mavericks have been at their finest form at the free throw line tonight. 8 attempts, 8 makes.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
He misses the free throw. A different look for Utah. Gobert comes in for Derek Favors. And it's Joe Ingles in for Jordan Clarkson. Then for the Mavericks, Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Dwight Powell. Luka Doncic comes in for Hardaway. And Josh Richardson subbed in for Burke. Good on the second free throw. 24 seconds left to play in the third. Against Mitchell. Mitchell is double. Gobert with a wide open look. Here's Ingles. Count the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
See, I think you want more of this from Joe Ingles. He has the size and length to keep plays alive.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
A guy in Joe Ingles who truly is an example of the right fit, the right organization makes all the difference in your career. Joe Ingles is a smart, tough, capable basketball player on both ends of the floor. He just needed the right place to show that.
And so it's Dallas, bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They're playing a bruising game inside, and it's working for them. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
Nothing better than chemistry, right? Working together to create a bucket.
And we're with you again as our round one coverage continues. On the floor for Dallas, starting the fourth quarter here. Kleba is the 4 with Porzingis in the middle. Jalen Brunson out there with Richardson. And it's Doncic in at the small forward position. And the basket is good.
very hard to contend with a player with the size and touch and well-rounded offensive game that Kristaps Porzingis has.
Here's Mitchell, and the shot is long.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus five in that category.
That's tipped. Ingles with the ball. Mitchell dishes to Bogdanović. Kicks it to Gobert. That ball. Nice feed that time from Bogdanović.
Well, Gobert is 7'1", and that in and of itself means he's difficult to contain. This guy really understanding how to play through contact. Well, they're trying to establish their attack down in the paint, and make no mistake, these help their overall confidence.
That's good from Richardson. A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. There's the pass to Ilyasova. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to blow the whistle.
I don't think there's any questions. There are so many rules that favor the offense these days. You've got to be able to equal things out when an illegal screen is set.
Mike Conley's checked in for the Jets.
For viewers, timeout's a chance to check your phone, grab a drink, but for the teams, it's all about business.
Well, there's something that the coach doesn't like. I'm curious to see which kind of adjustment he makes here.
Here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, during that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear Rick Carlisle's message to his team. His point to them was that they put themselves in a position to succeed and that this is their game to lose. So he needs to see full concentration out of every guy on the court to finish this one off. Kevin?
Well, you have to like the balance of Bojan Bogdanović. Keeping it through the contact, that is nicely done.
Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. Richardson outside. Back to Doncic. He kicks to Richardson. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That'll be his second foul of the game. On defense, Utah. They trail by 7. 6 to shoot. Shoots from the elbow.
I'll tell you, despite his struggles at the offensive end, this team still finds themselves in control of the ball game.
A nice shot by Bogdanović.
You know, put a rough first half behind him. He's absolutely crushing it here in the second.
Outside, Porzingis. Dallas again missing.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage play.
Yes, that goes in.
Well, how about the court awareness from Bogdanović showing off his ability to find the open man, Kevin?
Doncic gets to Brunson. Doncic outside. Goes up from the top of the key. And right on target. Good. Doncic has got 32 points in the game. Conley, the pass to Gobert. Mitchell dishes to Conley. Gobert down low. Goodbye, Doncic.
Absolute power from Rudy Gobert. Terrific out-muscling the defense.
A free throw drops for Gobert.
Well, we all know that free throw shooting early in his career was a major challenge for Rudy Gobert. What I like is he's made progress because he's put in the time.
Gobert with the block. Bogdanović passes it to Conley. Back to Bogdanović. Up again. It's good on the putback. Gobert's got it all tied up now for Utah.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Looking to get it going. Doncic trying to get open. Brunson, no good. To take the lead. That's good for Mitchell on the assist from Conley. Mitchell's got 27.
And you talk about fighting your way back into a lead. They've shown a lot of grit in this comeback.
Yeah, to start off with so many mistakes and still now find a way where everything's working, it allows their momentum and confidence to continue to build.
Tim Hardaway Jr.'s checked in for the Mavericks. It's Richardson on the wing, covered by Mitchell. Five to shoot. To end the run. That one wide left. And it's Mitchell with the ball for the Jazz. They've allowed just 7 points here in the fourth quarter.
Boy, 9 times out of 10, that's going in. I'm sure he surprised himself with the miss.
Doncic kicks to Richardson. Here's Porzingis, and it's in. Basket number 6 for him thus far. He has only missed 2 shots from the floor.
Boy, what a display of toughness from Kristaps Porzingis. He's a rock down low.
Here's Mitchell, and then Mitchell at the dunk.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. Kleba, the pass to Richardson. Out to Porzingis. Three-pointer. Rebound, Utah. Bogdanović has got 5 rebounds tonight. Conley, that ball. Nice feed that time from Bogdanović. And now a 4-point Utah lead. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need the basket.
Doncic with the bucket.
I'll tell you, Luka Doncic makes tough shots look easy. Boy, that close to the bucket through that much contact? Nice.
Gobert dishes to Mitchell. And then Mitchell with the dunk.
An aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. And with that shot, the Jazz lead is cut down to just 2 points on the bucket from Porzingis.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Mitchell outside. They double-team Conley. It's up a 3. And it's Mitchell missing. Dallas has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Hardaway, stolen by Michael Conley. Gets the bucket and the foul. That one on Richardson.
And it's coming easy for them right now. 5 baskets in a row in the paint.
And Utah making a change here. Favors has checked in. By 5. Doncic with it. Favors picks him up and he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
We are talking about a clever scorer. Luka Doncic has developed such a knack for getting to the free throw line.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
The first one falls. All free throws good from Doncic. Jazz leading by 3. Pass to Conley.
Here's Mitchell. Buries it from about 10 feet away. Mitchell's got 36.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score.
And Bogdanovich kicks to Mitchell. Porzingis with the block. And it's the Mavericks on the break. Porzingis has got the ball. Misses. Fourth time against seven makes for this game. Mitchell passes to Conley. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Mitchell's got six assists here tonight.
Well, Mike Conley, slight of frame, but the intention is there and finishes with contact.
Doncic outside. Connects from three-point range. Doncic has got 39.
Knocks that one down. Four triples for the night. Three in the first half.
Utah calls timeout.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
Player of the game, Donovan Mitchell.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
Jazz leading by four. Here's Conley. Mitchell with it. Hardaway picks him up. Favors. It's rebounded by Porzingis. Porzingis has got rebound number 13 for him here tonight. Near the three-point line, it's Doncic. Gets the jumper from the corner to fall. Doncic has got 41. And it's Conley with the ball for the Jazz. And it's Bogdanovich in the corner. Another miss by Utah. Dallas has gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Richardson, good.
How about the vision from the young Latvian Porzingis showing he really can read the floor and capitalize.
Mitchell passes to Favors. And here is Conley. On the wing, Ingles. And that one falls coming off Conley's feet. And the Jazz lead by three.
Well, he had trouble making shots in the first period, but rounding into himself here in the second.
It's good.
And since halftime, this has become an intense ball game.
They are getting after it hard. It has become a real battle out there.
Utah calls timeout.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Well, this is a chess match. Looking ahead a few moves and trying to execute toward that.
Utah leading. Here's Mitchell. Another shot. Nice D from Doncic. Mavericks shooting well here in the fourth quarter. 50%. Some room here for Richardson. Richardson missing again. Mitchell in the corner. Mitchell is double. high post, Favors. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It's on Porzingis.
Well, Derek Favors has absolutely a massive frame. Someone who can draw fouls due to his sheer size.
And the first one drops. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Mavericks trail by three. And here is Doncic. AD by Bogdanovic.
I'll tell you, most of the time, this guy's going to finish that. But that was tremendous defense that prohibits him from completing the play. My goodness, Joe Ingles, the poise, and on point in a big-time moment.
Doncic against Connell. And out of bounds as Utah gains possession. Here's Mitchell. We've got 1:28 left here in the fourth quarter. He dishes it to Favors. Back to Mitchell. Target from outside. Mavericks trail by five. Hardaway kicks to Porzingis. Doncic with it. Favors picks him up. Doncic with the bucket.
Doncic relishes the opportunity to deliver in big moments, and my goodness, embrace the spotlight, young man.
Here's Mitchell. Porzingis with the block. One-on-one here. Hardaway, that's a two-pointer. Money! And that shot brings them to within just one.
So much riding on that shot. What a bucket.
I'll tell you, that changes things, doesn't it? Good job, young fella. What a game.
Porzingis with the steal. Shot and game clock separated by five to take the lead. Bogdanovic grabs the miss, and now we've got the intentional foul.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
First free throw is good, and that will put them up by two. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
A bit of heroics at the line right there as he bumps their lead to three and makes things a little easier for them defensively.
Dallas calls timeout. They're trailing by three. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Doncic. Good! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
That's one of those clutch shots he's known for. When the pressure is high, he seems to be the most locked in.
Utah calls timeout. They're ahead by one. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
17 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And they foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point. Drops the first one, and that will put them up by two. So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game. And the Mavericks call time here. They're trailing by three. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
And it's do or die time. They need a bucket here to stay alive.
And it's either got to be a three-pointer or a score quickly and take the foul.
Porzingis. Now, here's Doncic. Good! And that shot brings them to within just one.
You've got to remember that Luka Doncic is so much more than a shooter. He's got every shot in his arsenal, even amongst the trees in there.
No choice but to foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
So the first one drops, and that will put them up by two. And so he drops them both. It's a three-point game.
Looking to tie it up with a big triple.
Greg, this is all about execution. Can you free an open man from the three-point line? That's what it comes down to.
Cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And the second of two is good. That gives them a four-point cushion. From deep. And so it's Utah who scraped by with the win. Things were looking bleak for him, obviously, coming into this game. But with tonight's win, Greg, they are right back in it.
And that's the fight this team has. They don't care what the odds are. They are going to keep battling. And suddenly, we got a series on our hands.
We sure do. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sidelines. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Rudy. This is a defense-first team. You picked it up in the second half. What changes did you make at the half?
I feel like we were focused in the first half defensively, and we just have to come back and communicate and just be focused, you know, and that's what we did.
Attention to detail, Rudy. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up, folks. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of the NBA Western Conference Quarterfinals. For Doris Burke, David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching.